This program is brought to you by the Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC.
This is NDDC Today.
Good evening, nice you can join us again. Now, the NDDC has been a spectacle for some time, managing impressions, both public impressions and being able to stay on an even keel and focus on the raison d'etre of the commission is not an easy thing, particularly when you have one administrator having to think of all those things with the assistance of his directors, with so many expectations of the NDDC. Everything that happens in the NDDC now becomes a national topic. So the people who are now thinking and running the place are on their toes every day, trying to see how to meet with the different expectations of the different stakeholders. Now, if you noticed recently, the administrator set up a committee for, you know, the seasoned officers of the commission to go around the projects of the commission to see those that are ready for commissioning so that they can be commissioned, and those with a little problem still in the wings to see how they can do to fast track everything. Well, this week we have good reports for you from Akwa Ibom State, where our correspondent visited 8 projects and found out what was happening there. This is Patrick Oke. Welcome to NDDC Today. Now, from its rich endowment in hydrocarbon, the Niger Delta region is also blessed with abundant human capital resources, numbering over 30 million people. Of this number, a significant percentage of the population comprise of persons living with different forms of disability. The NDDC over the years has given special attention to this category of persons by way of sustainable livelihood. Last week, a delegation from the Niger Delta Region chapter of the Joint Association of Persons Living with Disabilities visited the NDDC to seek support from the Commission to better their lot. Of course, they met a listening ear in the person of the interim administrator, who is so concerned about the lot of the disabled in the region, Mr. Efio Akwa, from where our reporter filed in this report.
The legal definitions of physically challenged or disabled people are persons living with physical or mental conditions which prevent them from performing normally. In Nigeria, the number of persons living with disabilities is above 20 million and are persistently faced with stigmatization, discrimination, and barriers to accessing basic social services and economic opportunities. In March 2019, the Nigerian Senate passed a bill outlawing discrimination against persons with disabilities. At the time, many considered the law a major milestone on the rights of the physically challenged in our society. Since then, nothing seems to have changed. These scenarios had several times compelled the Coalition of Persons Living with Disabilities in the Niger Delta to protest in order to attract government attention and tell their own story of abandonment in the midst of plenty. The NDDC headquarters in Port Harcourt has always been their major port of call over the years, until December 2020, when they took their protest to the Nigerian Senate in Abuja to press home their demands.
When we arrived here, we wrote a letter to the Deputy Senate President, which Omar Gege, for World Disability Day and Christmas package. Senate President advised us that we should copy that letter we gave to Omar Gege to share it cut across the Niger Delta senators, so they will all look into it and do something tangible for us.
Recently in Port Harcourt, the interim administrator of the Niger Delta Development Commission, Mr. Efiong Akwa, reaffirmed the commitment of the commission to assist people living with disabilities and give them sustainable livelihoods. Mr. Akwa gave this assurance when he received a delegation from the Niger Delta chapter of the Joint National Association of Persons Living with Disabilities at the NDDC headquarters in Port Harcourt. He said, the NDDC is committed to the well-being and overall development of members of the association.
It is incumbent on us on annual basis during your International Day of Persons Living with Disability, we shall continue to send our support, our minimum support.
The NDDC Chief Executive Officer announced that the Commission would offer contract employment to one member of the association from each of the 9 Niger Delta states.
Let me announce to you that we will give a contract employment to one person living disability per state for the 9 states.
He noted that the new NDDC headquarters made special provisions to assist persons living with disabilities to enable them have easy access to the building through roll-on and roll-off walkways. Responding to the demands of the association, Mr. Akwa stated that the NDDC does not utilize contract projects for empowerment, as development projects affect millions of lives in the Niger Delta region. He noted that NDDC, as an interventionist agency, is concerned with sustainable development projects. Akwa praised persons living with disability for doing Nigeria proud during the 2016 Olympic Games by winning gold for the country. He thanked them for their vote, which helped the Buhari administration come into power. Earlier, in an address presented on behalf of the regional chairman of the Joint National Association of Persons Living with Disabilities, Mr. Simon Bide, the coordinator of the group, Prince Akaninyene Isidore, promised that the group would no longer be confrontational in making its demands. The chairman said that the vulnerable and disadvantaged group at grassroots usually suffer untold hardship, neglect, gross discrimination, deprivation and stigmatization. He appealed to the Commission to integrate persons with disabilities as stakeholders in the Niger Delta region during the reintroduction of the new Niger Delta Regional Development Master Plan.
Some assurances there from the NDDC Interim Administrator to continue to address the challenges faced by persons living with disabilities in the Niger Delta. Now, moving on, the NDDC is set to commission a 64-flat residential quarters and administrative block it constructed to ease accommodation challenges for security personnel in Rivers State. The NDDC Interim Administrator recently embarked on the inspection of this project to assess work at the site. Our correspondent was on his entourage and brought this update.
The Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC, says it will soon commission a 64-flat residential quarters and administrative block for security personnel in Rivers State. Speaking while inspecting the residential quarters built for senior security personnel, the NDDC Interim Administrator, Mr. Ifeanyi Akwa, stated that the project would add value to the living conditions of security officers posted to work in Rivers State. He said that the commission was created for the purpose of intervening in the life of the people of the Niger Delta, stating that the project was a demonstration of the importance the commission attached to security in the Niger Delta region. Akwa remarked that the commission intervened in the housing subsector because it realized that when federal public servants were transferred to Port Harcourt as the regional headquarters of the South-South region, housing was usually an issue.
Persons transferred to Rivers State were asking for different payment with respect to housing allowances and so on. And some of them wouldn't even refuse to come. And because of that, most of them were ineffective. So NDDC decided to intervene in the housing subsector by providing house for senior security officers that may be posted to Rivers State so that they can be more effective to the government, they can be more effective to the people, and they can secure environment.
The NDDC boss said that the completion of the project was another major achievement of the President Muhammadu Buhari's administration, noting that when people say that NDDC is not working, they can see that that is not true.
when people say that NDDC has nothing to do, NDDC is just members of the public castigate NDDC. It's because most of these things have not been publicized. Can you see this? Most state government don't have the capacity to put up this.
The residential flats and administrative buildings have been completed and would soon be commissioned. The NDDC boss promised to clear all outstanding interim payment certificates, IPCs, to enable the contractors to put finishing touches to the project. He thus gave the contractors 3 weeks to complete the finishing touches and hand over the project to the commission. He said that this investment is going to help in improving security in Rivers State, especially in the vicinity of the airport. It will surely enhance the security of the Port Harcourt International Airport, and it will also add value to the economic and social life in the area. Commenting on the project, one of the contractors, Mr. Stanley Arua, noted that it was started in 2013 and was supposed to be completed in 8 months. He regretted that delays in the release of funds stalled the project. He said that despite the funding challenges, the contractors still continue to work to ensure the completion of the project, affirming that the job would be fully done if money was released for the final touches.
We have completed this project to a conclusive point. We just need some punch lists clearing, some few clearing of the remaining items to finish. So if we are funded as the director has promised us, we are going to complete this job within the 3 weeks specified by him.
Now, as we told you in previous editions of NDDC Today, Akwa Ibom State ranks as the largest producer of oil in the country, contributing about 31% of Nigeria's total oil output. It is no wonder then that the state will attract a big percentage of NDDC's interventions in infrastructure and human development. And rightly so, the NDDC has continued to open up several rural communities in the state through its many road projects scattered across the state, as well as the rehabilitation of educational facilities and provision of basic amenities such as pipe-borne water in some parts of the state. Our correspondent was in Akwa Ibom State recently, and this is what he brought back.
Empirical evidence shows that infrastructural development is a major enabler of economic growth, and Nigeria's Niger Delta, which is blessed with an abundance of natural resources, including crude oil and arable land, has for a long time yearned for basic infrastructure that would stimulate economic prosperity in its region. The Niger Delta Development Commission, NDDC, saddled with the responsibility of getting infrastructural development to the nooks and crannies of the Niger Delta region, has not failed to acknowledge the position Akwa Ibom holds among the oil-producing states in the Niger Delta. As a result, NDDC has stepped up its developmental drive in Akwa Ibom State in so many ways. One of such examples is the construction of a staff quarters, a principal's residence, and renovation of blocks of classrooms at the Igbohu Community Secondary School in Igbohu in Mbo local government area of Akwa Ibom State. The staff quarters and the principal's residence are tastefully furnished with sets of furniture and television sets in all the flats. They also have air conditioners provided by the Niger Delta Development Commission for the comfort of residents, and which has made the school the envy of all the surrounding educational institutions. The staff of the school, who hitherto had to endure the grueling journey of travelling from far and wide to come to work in Igbohu Community Secondary School, can now finally heave a sigh of relief by this gesture of the NDDC to provide them with accommodation in the school they live in and work. The renovation of the classrooms has left the students with words of gratitude to the NDDC for coming to their aid by providing them with desks and tables for their learning comfort.
The project has helped us a lot, like the classroom block here. Students now stay here conducively and obtain their education. And the teachers that were living in far distance are now able to live near to the school compound to teach us in their normal time.
I thank God for everything. and also to thank NDCC for the project that is being done in our school. I'm very, very proud of it.
Expressing his happiness over the construction and renovations which the NDDC carried out in his school, the principal, Mr. Henry Akpabio, noted that the development can only spur the teachers to deliver their best to the students.
We'll encourage the teachers to work hard because now we have very many of them, and with what we have in the equipment and whatever, they are happy to stay around, and it will boost their work.
I've been paying my transport from Uyo to the school every day. But fortunately, I'm very happy that I'm staying in the NDC quarters, well furnished. If I sleep there, I'm very comfortable.
Moving on, this is Nauku, a community in Uyo local government area of Akwa Ibom State. For the people of this community, access to clean, potable water has been a major issue. To curb the various waterborne diseases caused by consuming unclean, unsafe and unhygienic water by the people of Nauku, NDDC has completed a solar-powered water project to provide them with the much-needed clean, potable water. According to the United Nations General Assembly, through Resolution 64-292, every human being has the right to have access to sufficient water for personal and domestic use, which must be safe, acceptable, affordable, and physically accessible. Expressing their joy that the days of fetching unsafe and unhygienic water from different sources are gone, inhabitants of Nauku are full of praise for the NDDC for citing this water project in their community.
Usually when sun is shining, that's when the water will come up. So many people fetch the water.
I truly love it, that the way they do it, the water for us to live.
Still in Uyo local government area, the Niger Delta Development Commission has completed remedial work on the once unmotorable Aniete Ufot Crescent Road at Shelter Afrique Estate to ease the problems inhabitants of the estate have had to endure in the past. The project has now been completed and has brought immense relief to residents of the estate who before now had to endure the deplorable conditions of the road. The roads have also improved the social life and economic development of the estate while also serving as a major access to schools and other public facilities in the neighborhood.
I'm very, very happy because formerly this wasn't how the road was. It was rough. And now it is okay for us to apply, even to take someone across from Shelter to Afaratai. So we are normally using here, you can see Ekeke passing. That is the route we use to far. Sometimes we link to Nwate. So I really appreciate the people that do it.
The NDDC have really tried a lot. If you can see, the whole environment have been tied up by them.
The development strides carried out in Akwa Ibom State by the NDDC are also felt in other communities in the state. The people of Ikot Antia in Uruan local government area of the state are besides themselves for the construction of a major access road in their community by the NDDC. The road, which is provided with culverts and drainages, could not have come any sooner, as the residents have had great difficulty moving around the community in the past due to the terrible state of the road.
It was so bad, especially during rainy season. When rain will be passing here, it will be very difficult for someone to ride bicycle, including motor, not even to talk of the pedestrian, they will be walking.
Some residents acknowledged and thanked the NDDC for the good work done on the road, as they noted that the road has now improved the well-being and standard of living of people, while economic and social activities have also improved.
This road is a very good. I have ride this road both night and afternoon. There's no error.
People are coming in and enjoy the road. So even in the night, we enjoy the road. Even though you old touch, you know old touch, you enjoy the road. We like it too.
Still on roads, work has now been completed on the road project in Ibiabong Ikot Ofyong community, in Ibiaku Ntogokpo community in Ekono local government area by the NDDC. Before now, inhabitants of the adjoining communities could only move and commute on foot and bicycles, as the link roads could best be described as pathways until the NDDC intervened to open up the Ibiabong Ikot Ofyong Road, cutting across four communities to allow for easy vehicular and human activities. Highlighting the scope of work done on the 1.4 kilometer road, which is 7.2 meters wide, with one-sided drainage system. A representative of the contractor, Samuel Mbada, stressed that the quality of work carried out on the road was done as stipulated by the NDDC, while noting that the cooperation of the entire community helped to ensure the successful completion of the road project.
The road, as you can see here now, we are working according to the demands of NDDC as directed by the Bill of Quantity. The drains, the way it should be, and the asphalt, the real quality and the right equipment used. That's what you see the road to be the way it is today.
Also speaking on the road project, Okorie Samson, a resident, while appreciating what the NDDC has done, observed that the road was impassable in the past, and with the construction of this road, development has finally come to his people.
A lot of things are happening in the road. In fact, you can see a lot of people have started developing their place. The farm produce is very easy to move now, very easy, courtesy of NDDC.
A woman leader observed that the pains they went through in the past to transport their goods was now a thing of the past, as they are now able to move their goods to the marketplace without stress.
We move our goods to the market very freely, unlike before, that we couldn't make good use of this road.
Describing the construction of the road as a blessing to the benefiting communities, a community chairman, like Oliver Twist, requested that the Niger Delta Development Commission should also assist the community in other beneficial projects. Another road that has gotten the attention of the Niger Delta Development Commission in Akwa Ibom State is this 3-kilometer-long Ikot Ido Eternal Road in Ona local government area. The condition of this road has over the years been a source of worry to the residents of Ikot Edo community, who have had to endure with the difficulty of commuting around and out of their community due to the dilapidated state of their roads, which gets worse during the rainy season. With the construction of this road, the excitement of residents of Ikot Edo community is palpable.
The road is a nice project because when you have a good project like this, you thank the people that bring it.
We thank the NDDC so much for their effort, for their assistance they have given to our community to have this kind of road. A road we never expected we would have it in the next 20 to 30 years ahead.
To have easy access to farmlands by farmers and to enhance the security of the area by providing security agents with good motorable roads, the NDDC has completed the Iboro, Ikot Ufot, Ikot Anya Road in Ikot Abasi in Akwa Ibom State. The road, which is now 100% complete, is already in use and is expected to attract more developmental projects to the community. Work carried out on this project include sclarification of failed sections, removal of unsuitable materials and replacement with suitable ones, sharp sand filling, stone bays, priming, asphalting of the surface and culverts and drains. Prior to the commencement of this project, the road was in a terrible state that whenever it rained, the situation became worse due to the sloppy nature of the road. But the new look of the road has helped in the transportation of agricultural produce to neighboring markets.
It is okay now because we can pass here easily, no problem. Any vehicle can pass through it and we can transport our food items to another market here in Uduawa from the Oruanam side.
The completion of the Iboro, Ikot Ufot, Ikot Anya Road has also reduced the journey to Port Harcourt and neighboring cities. Here in Ididep Ekpenyong Ikot Etim in Ibiono local government area, residents are benefiting from the commitment of the NDDC to open up every nook and cranny of the Niger Delta region for infrastructural and human development with construction work on their road. Before now, the Ididep community had been plagued with dilapidated roads that had hampered easy movement of residents in and around the area. The road in the past was filled with potholes and several sections washed off by erosion, which made it virtually impassable. The total length of the road, which is 10.125 kilometers, about 7.8 kilometers of it have been asphalted with drainages and culverts and is now in use. It has helped change the fortunes of the communities straddling along it. While appreciating the intervention of the NDDC, Imet Efiong Ude, a trader, thanked the NDDC for a job well done.
Since we branched to Ikore Ekpenyong to Afara, till Ikorotem to Ntanbat, the road is very nice. I thank God.
By the time the Iboro Ikot Ufot Ikot Anya Road is complete, driving on the road will be less stressful for its users and will also serve as a route through which agricultural products and other commodities can be transported to neighboring markets.
Beneficiaries of NDDC gestures in communities in Akwa Ibom State expressing their gratitude for the intervention of the Commission in their domain. It is hoped that several more communities across the region will also feel the impact of the interventionist agency in the provision of the much-needed development projects. Well, thank you very much. That's all we have for today, and it's been quite a while.